where we're working with a specific insect, wax moths. Those insects are able to digest plastic and polymeric materials, which we are producing every day in our everyday life. The plastic we are focusing on is unrecyclable plastic. It means that we are focusing on lasting waste streams where we have mixtures, when we have copper emeralds, smooth packaging, all those materials that cannot be recycled by other means. So we are clearly here to replace the incineration, and it's worth to know that during the incineration, for each and every kilogram of burned plastic and polymeric materials, 2.5 kilograms of CO2 are liberated in our atmosphere. And our process is reducing CO2 emissions by 67%. So basically, the discovery was made by chance. People who were working with those specific insects for completely different purposes. They had them in a plastic bag and they got lazy, but left them overnight in this bag. And when they came the other morning, they have seen holes in the bag and insects everywhere. And they discovered that the insects were able to digest those plastic materials. So our goal is to go towards commercial units, which will be transforming 60,000 tons of plastic waste per year, which will be generating 20,000 tons of larvae. At the end of the process, we are separating it into proteins and lipids that can be used for feed industries, and the poop process of the insect is used as biofertilizer. We have two different types of customers. First hand, we have customers that are interested by our service of handling of plastic waste, because as we are targeting the ultimate plastic waste with lasting waste streams, so that people are used to send to the incineration, and it's a costly procedure. So by offering a little bit lower prices than the incineration, we're actually capturing the interest of those customers. On the other hand, with the products that we are getting, the proteins and lipids, so we also have customers of our final products. So it's kind of a B-sided business model. When we are talking about circularity on Earth, it's kind of a nice have. But when we are talking about a long-distance space trip, the circularity is no longer a nice have, it's a must have. So it becomes very mandatory to have this type of circular system when you are kind of reintroducing a waste from one branch to be a resource material for another one. So for feeding the astronauts and handling their waste, it's really interesting to have this insect process.